Hey, what's going on, you guys? My name is the Rappter, and today is May 22nd, 2018, which means that today marks the 2-year anniversary of Who'd Win and Why. I'm gonna be real with you guys, it does not feel like it's been 2 years, and over the course of those 2 years, we've had 8 full seasons. That's 80 episodes in all, which is freaking ridiculous. In fact, when we started Who'd Win and Why, I don't even think I had 100 subscribers, and that was after the 2-year mark for my channel in general. And now 2 years after that, with Who'd Win and Why in the mix, we're well over 600 subscribers, and that is absolutely insane. So I want to give a huge thank you to everyone who's been involved in the show, and thank you for taking an interest in it. It's one of the things that I love to do just in general, and I'm so glad you guys are able to find enjoyment out of it as well. And so to celebrate this momentous occasion, what I've decided to do is rank all 8 seasons of Who'd Win and Why from worst to best in my personal opinion. And this is going to encompass everything, such as the quality of the episodes themselves, how much fun I enjoy making the seasons, individual issues I have with the episodes in the seasons, etc., etc. And obviously, this is just my personal opinion, and some of you guys might like certain seasons that I don't like, and vice versa. And that's perfectly fine. This is all just my personal opinion. However, I have thought long and hard about what seasons I would put where, and I think I have a good concrete list. So without further ado, let's get right into it. So to kick off this list, my number 8 spot would definitely have to be season 5. This season had a number of problems, at least it did for me. When it came to actually putting together the season and picking the episodes, it was really rather hard because not a lot of people were actually suggesting Christmas episodes. They were suggesting episodes for season 6, the next regular season in the list, and that made it harder to narrow down the episodes for that season consequently. You can also tell by looking back at the season that there are some episodes that don't really have that much to do with Christmas, especially the season finale, Batman vs. Iron Man 2, where it was more so passed off as my Christmas gift to the viewers. So yeah, that didn't really make a lot of sense. The season also seemed to get a little bit repetitive for me, as a lot of the characters used were either ice characters or Christmas characters, which does make sense because it was a Christmas season. And I'm not sure about you guys, but looking back at the episodes, I'm really not a huge fan of that Santa hat or the Santa beard, especially the beard. I now hate that beard. And you know, it was actually a little bit stressful for me to actually, you know, produce these episodes on time because I was trying to get them all out before Christmas, and I ultimately failed at that, so that was not great. In terms of the quality of the episodes themselves, I like to think that they were pretty okay for the most part, like they were decent episodes, but I have too many individual problems with the season for me to place it anywhere higher than number 8 on my list. My number 7 pick would have to be season 1. I'm sure a lot of you guys saw this coming, that it was going to be lower on the list. This season was extremely rough. It was really hard to find the footing for this season, and it is definitely nowhere near the quality of what Who, When, and Why is today. The stuttering in those videos was pretty excessive. Believe me, if you think I still stutter through my videos now, it was way worse all the way back then. The research was not quite as good, and I think for the first 2 episodes, there wasn't even really any research done for it at all. It was just me talking about everything I knew about the characters involved. And because there weren't as many people watching Who'd Win Why back then, a lot of the episodes were being suggested by the same people. Like, I think 7 of the episodes were all suggested by one person. So I don't have a lot of specific problems with this season, but I think I've made myself clear for why I put this season as low as I do. My number 6 spot would have to be season 3. Season 3 has general issues in the sense that I still stutter through the videos a little bit, and I don't interpret the research as best I could, but there are also some things in that season that really bug me. The reasoning behind some of the episodes in that season could be considered questionable to some. If you were watching those videos back then, you probably know what I'm talking about, and there are just some episodes in there where I look at that and I'm thinking, I could do that so much better now. I was also trying to relatively rush through this season because I was trying to make sure that I started the next season, season 4, the Halloween season, before Halloween started, or before that Halloween time started. So I wasn't having as much fun making that season as I've had other seasons. Not to mention that the season finale, the movie Spider-Man Battle Royale, that one is basically proven to be wrong now, considering, you know, what we've seen the MCU Spider-Man do across the 3 movies. So yeah, that episode still bugs me. It's still my least favorite episode to this day. I'm not trying to say season 3 was terrible. There are still some things I quite like about it, but I do still put it as number 6 on my list because there are a number of things that just really I don't like about it. My number 5 spot would have to be season 2. Season 2 has some of the same general problems as season 3 does, but I don't have as many specific issues with it, and there are some things about it that I feel redeem it in some ways. This season was made over the course of basically the entire summer, and that meant that it didn't feel nearly as rushed as season 3 did. It meant that I was actually able to analyze the information better, and it meant that I had more fun making season 2 than I did season 3. I also have to mention that I don't have as many issues with the individual episodes as I did season 3, and it had the first team battle, you know, Civil War, and that was a really cool experiment. I also think that the battles in season 2 are a little bit better than the battles in season 3, but not by too much, and that's just me. Overall, this season is still not great, it still only earns a number 5 spot on my list, but I do think that it is a little bit better than some of the other weaker seasons out there. My number 4 spot would have to be, well, season 4. I know that season 4 was the Halloween season, which meant that it was a holiday season just like the Christmas season was, but I feel like the Halloween season was much better than the Christmas season ever was. A lot of you guys were really eager to suggest episodes for that season, and we ended up getting some great battles out of that, involving scary good guys, scary bad guys, and even horror icons. And some of you guys may disagree with this, but I personally thought that the lighting choice for that season, where I made everything darker, wasn't too bad. At least it was definitely much better than the Santa hat and Santa beard that I did for the Christmas season. To me, season 4 was really when Who'd Win and Why started to take a turn for the better. Seasons 1, 2, and 3 are all really rough and could have been done so much better, but season 4 was when I really felt that I started to get my act together and, well, make better episodes, so I definitely have to like that season for that. There is the same issue that the Christmas season had in the sense that I was trying to get all the episodes out while Halloween was still relevant, and that didn't go too well for me, but overall, with everything else considered, I do think that this season deserves the number 4 spot on my list. My number 3 spot would have to be season 7. Based on the comments on the episodes of that season, it seemed like a lot of you guys really enjoyed season 7, and I really enjoyed it too. The quality of most of the episodes in that season is really high up there in my opinion, and that was actually the season when I started adopting a new note-taking and memorizing strategy, which I think has really helped me in the more recent episodes. Plus, it has the season finale of Sentry vs. Superman, which is one of my favorite season finales of all time in Who'd Win and Why. There were also other individual episodes that I really liked doing, such as Batman vs. Daredevil and Splinter vs. Shifu. However, the reason why it is lower on the list than some of the other more recent seasons is because there were some episodes which I wasn't quite happy with, such as Salmon vs. Clayface most notably, and also even Bane vs. Johnny Cage. That being said, however, I still like to think that season 7 was a pretty solid season. It seemed like a lot of you guys really enjoyed it, and I can definitely understand why. However, there are still 2 seasons that I personally think are better than season 7, and here they are. My number 2 spot would have to be season 6. Season 6 and season 7 are basically neck and neck for me. I like them almost equally, but there are some parts of season 6 that I feel really makes it stand out. First of all, the vast majority of the episodes in that season, I am still very proud of. I don't have too many regrets about what I said in those episodes, and I still just like to think that overall, those episodes were really well made. Season 6 was one of those seasons where I really felt like I had fun making the season from beginning to end. There was really no dull point in this season for me. I had so much fun doing it. Plus, Thanos versus Darkseid, the season finale of that fight, I like to think that that is the best season finale we've had so far on Who'd Win Why, so that's gotta count for something. And that's still a fight that I really want to see Death Battle do one day to see if I'm proven wrong or right. There are little kinks with this season, obviously, as there is with every season, but overall, I think that this is one of my favorite seasons, and just one of the best. It's one of the ones where I had the most fun making the episodes, and I think the episodes themselves are just pretty well made, so I would definitely say that it is my number 2 spot. And lastly, coming in at number 1, we have Season 8. Now, I'm sure a lot of you guys probably saw this coming. I really enjoyed Season 8. It is my favorite Season 2 date, and I would say that it is probably the highest point of Who'd Win Why in general so far. In my opinion, Season 8 has the best selection of battles of any Who'd Win Why season so far, and it involves some of my favorite episodes, such as Scorpion vs. Ghost Rider and Thor vs. Shazam, and it even involves my favorite episode of Who'd Win Why ever, being Batman vs. Black Panther. I feel that this season has the best quality of any episodes ever on the show, which makes sense considering that we're talking about the most recent season of Who'd Win Why, and this is the season that I actually started to put real editing into the videos, which I think is really going to help out, you know, later down the line for future seasons. Above all, however, this season was the most fun season to make by far. I know that in general I do have fun making Who'd Win Why episodes because, you know, if I didn't, what's the point of making it? But this one in particular was so fun to make. A reason for that was probably because of the selection of episodes that I got this time around, but it was also because you guys were so into it, and the channel was at the highest it's ever been before, the show in general, you know, Who'd Win Why was at the highest it's ever been before, and you guys guys were so involved and it seemed like you guys were having a lot of fun. So I was having a lot of fun, you guys were having a lot of fun. I don't really see how I could have asked for more. So I would definitely say that season 8 is my number one Who'd Win Why season. But now I want to hear what you guys have to say. Did you guys agree with my list, or do you really like some seasons that I just didn't like too much? If so, no matter what, let me know down in the comments below, because I'd really like to hear what you guys think about all of this. And as always, make sure to give this video a huge like. I always appreciate the likes. Comment on what you thought of it, what you thought of the video, what you thought of the seasons, anything like that. And if you guys could subscribe to my channel, that'd be so great. That would really help my channel out. But before I sign off here, I just want to say something about Who'd Win Why in general. Yes, I am aware that the season 9 schedule video did come out a really long time ago, and I still haven't made any season 9 episodes yet. And to that, I just want to say that I am so sorry. I know that school is probably a big reason for this, because, you know, high school sucks. Like, it takes up so much of my time, and we're getting to the exam season now, so that really sucks. But another big reason for that is probably because I just haven't been devoting as much time to the channel and to Who Win Why itself as much as I should be. To be fair, I'm not sure how much that would have actually helped, because I'm not really sure how much free time I have right now because of school and exams, but I will try to make sure that I do devote more time to the season, you know, after this video comes up. So basically starting right now. And who knows, maybe this is actually a good thing, because, you know, Solo is going to be coming out soon, and I might be able to factor that into Captain Kirk vs. Han Solo, which is the next episode of Who Win Why. But regardless, I'm just trying to let you guys know that I am going to try to be better in terms of, you know, devoting more time to the season. And if the episodes still do come out at a relatively slower rate, I just hope you guys can understand. Regardless, however, thank you guys so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And thank you for sticking around for as long as you have with Who'd Win and Why, because Who'd Win and Why is still something that I love to do, and you guys are a big reason for that. And whether or not you were here since the beginning, or you're relatively new, or you came somewhere in the middle of this crazy roller coaster ride, I want to thank every single one of you, because it seems like you guys are really enjoying it, and that's one of the big reasons why I enjoy it. So thanks for all the support and all the views and everything like that, because it really means so much to me. And again, thank you so much for watching this video, because it does really mean so much. You guys are the best. So that's it for me. See you later, and have a good night. Peace out.